We're out here in the middle of South Bay right now to collect eelgrass seeds to restore more eelgrass in the system. But South Bay is a coastal bay on the Atlantic coast of Virginia's Eastern Shore. And it's one of many bays on the Atlantic coast of Virginia's Eastern Shore that used to have eelgrass all over it. And this eelgrass all disappeared by 1933 thanks to a disease that was killing eelgrass all over the North Atlantic, and possibly because of a big storm that came through in 1933 as well. And the system had been without any eelgrass at all for just about 70 years until a couple of patches showed up right here at the north end of this bay in the late 90s. And it got the Virginia Institute of Marine Science interested in really figuring out how to get more grass back here. And through that, through their work, they figure out the system we're using today, where we can actually harvest seeds from these plants in the spring and then plant those seeds in the fall. And it turns out that works really well. You know, after 70 years of having no eelgrass out here at all, we've planted somewhere around 600 acres, and we have around 9,000 acres. So what we plant is growing, and that grass is actually expanding again. So it's been a very good project. And it's important that we're doing this too, because as the eelgrass has come back, we're starting to get certain fish species back using this grass. We're starting to get more crabs back in the grass that can hide and shed and become soft crabs for a little while as they grow. We're starting to get some of the fish that we like to fish for. So things like speckled trout and red drum use this habitat to hide if they're little, but mostly to eat the little fish that are hiding around. And really importantly, we're working at figuring out how to bring bay scallops back to Virginia, because bay scallops depend on this habitat to survive. We used to have a lot of bay scallops in Virginia. It was a big fishery, but when we lost that grass in 1933, we lost all of our bay scallops. So it's important habitat for all kinds of living things. And then it does a lot of other things for the physical environment too, not just the living stuff. So having this grass out here helps to dampen wave energy. So as waves roll across this bay, they won't erode that marsh behind me quite as quickly, because the grass takes the power out of those waves. The grass holds the sediments in place, so we don't get a lot of sediment clouding up the water, and we don't get a lot of sediment filling up our navigable waterways or covering our oyster reefs. This grass actually helps to fight against ocean acidity, and it also stores a lot of carbon that we would rather have stored buried underground rather than up in the air where it affects climate change. So it's important to get this stuff back, and we're lucky to have so many people that have helped with this project, like they're out here helping today, to pick these seeds so we can continue to expand the amount of eelgrass that's out here. So a little bit about what everybody's doing today. We're snorkeling around in this grass bed. In this time of year, eelgrass is making two kinds of shoots. So most of the time, eelgrass has vegetative shoots. These are just basically what you see above the surface, is just leaves. They're long, they're really smooth, flat, very green, unbranched leaves. Kind of like a piece of tape. If you feel it through your fingers, let it slide through your fingers, you'll feel what it feels like, because I think getting a feel for it is handy too. That's most of it. But this time of year, for the past few months, the eelgrass has been producing flowering shoots, reproductive shoots, and these are the shoots that have seeds in them right now. I want you to look at, here's a good one of these. These look a little bit different. Instead of having the really long, flat green leaves, they're more branched, lots of shorter little branches. If you look at the stalks of these, instead of being flat and green, it's really skinny, coarse, almost white in color. And if you look at the tips of each of these are called spathes, and these are where the flowers developed, and now they've turned into seeds, and the seeds in these are just getting ready to be released from the plants. So we want to grab as many of these while we can before all the seeds have popped out, and bring them into our tanks and oysters.